One of the biggest fears that people that we work with have is call reluctance, especially when it comes to cold calling. People will do anything to get away from picking up the phone and calling a stranger and talking to them. So I want to show you in this video just how easy and fun it is. We're going to sit down. I'm here in the CRM, Collect. This is the one that we built on top of Go High Level to really make sure we supercharge everything for you guys. But we're going to just hit the phones and see what happens. So let's get rolling.
Please leave your message for 4145.
So one of the most fun things about this is the anticipation as you wait for them to answer the phone.
Six, four, seven, four, two.
So one of the things I found is it generally will take about 10 to 15 dials before you get a pickup. Terrence.
Hello.
Hey man, how you been?
I've been good.
Good man, what's new?
Who am I speaking with?
It's Mike.
Cool.
Mike, you reached out a little while ago because I think you're trying to get more clients and scale up your business.
Oh, okay, yes. How you doing?
Good man, what's new?
Nothing much.
Yeah? You been busy this week?
Have I been busy?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Sweet, man. Are you still looking to get more clients or generate leads?
I am at this moment, not at this moment.
So you are, but not right now, is what you're saying?
Oh, well, I'm not looking to invest right now.
No, I wasn't asking about investing. I was just wondering if you're getting more leads.
Oh, getting more leads.
Yeah.
No, well, yes, I am interested in getting more leads.
But remind me what you do. I remember you had Dreamworld, right? That's your company?
Yes, I do have Dreamworld Media Group. That is correct. A digital marketing agency.
And that's the one you're trying to generate leads for, or is it a different business?
No, it's the same business. I kind of got into the SaaS, to help with Dreamworld Media Group.
So you're right now and Go High Level or something?
Yes, I am.
Yeah, nice. Yeah. I love GHL.
Yeah, so that's, I just recently, me and my wife had spoke about it. I'm still on the trial right now.
Yeah.
So just setting everything up. I did get someone to purchase and use the SaaS. So.
Congrats, man. That's awesome.
Thank you.
How about the agency stuff? How's that going?
Not going too well because the website went down because I decided to part ways with the person who did the website and stuff like that.
Really? Yeah, so I just had a Wix site when I checked it out. I didn't realize that was what happened.
Yeah, I parted ways with that. And then especially with now that I got under... got with Go High Level, I have to rebuild my, rebuild my site and put it back up through Go High Level.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And I really haven't had a chance to do so at this moment in time because I was getting my wife's stuff set up. We moved her website and did everything, moved her stuff over under Go High Level and stuff like that because of what happened and transpired last year with the person who...
Just the balling out. Your wife has a business too?
Yeah, so she is a business coach for hairstylists and beauty professionals, helping them teach them how to run their business, scale their business by using the stuff that she's learned and done over the past 20 years to help her be successful in the hair industry.
Yeah, that's sick.
And then she's been getting a lot of contacts where people see something like different from her coaching hairstylist, because I apparently what she does and how she does it and everything else could help other businesses outside of hairstylists and stuff. So I had to get her up and running first before I even thought about doing my Journey World Media Group.
I get that. Website. And that's a good niche too. We have a couple of clients that do multi six figures a month on that niche. So the beauty and stylist niche.
Yeah, the problem was she's had five, six successful students go through the program, and then now she just got two more students in that signed up off of her her YouTube channel.
She got a YouTube?
Yeah, so she does a lot. Well, she did. She hasn't started the second season. She won't start the second season until after the Christmas holidays. But the first season went great. So a lot of her students have been coming through, and her leads been coming through YouTube.
Season meaning like a season of a YouTube series, or season meaning like a cohort of clients that are enrolled in the program?
No, so she does live shows with... she does a live show with bringing other entrepreneurs in, and they do like a podcasting type show, live show.
Oh, that's tight. How many subs does she have on YouTube?
How many subs?
Yeah.
Right now she is at 328, I believe.
328?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. YouTube, man, is the best. Like, especially once you get it to catch, the lead quality is so high. The we've been pushing our YouTube channel as well, and it's been a godsend for sure. I feel like too, like YouTube's a window, because you know, like the thing about YouTube is now everyone's starting to wake up to what it is, so you're starting to see a lot more big money come in with higher production, like, you know, like I don't know if you watch Drink Champs, like I love Drink Champs, but it's like, I mean, like when you got Diddy coming in and dropping M's on stuff, it's, you know, it's a different game.
Right. Yeah. And at first she was focusing too much on Instagram, trying to get leads through Instagram, which Instagram is not really a good place to get leads as far as for what she was doing. So her students have been coming through.
It's weird, man. It's good to get leads, but it's not good to make them like know, like, and trust her. Like YouTube gets the leads where their money, like when they come to the call, like they already got their wallet out. You know what I mean? But on Instagram, it's like you got to do a lot to get them to that place. But it's really good to get top of funnel traffic, especially for her niche. But it's not good as much to get them like through the nurture process as YouTube is.
Right.
Yeah. And the other thing that's interesting, and I think like why I like YouTube a lot more, is because, YouTube does a lot better job of consistently giving you traffic, whereas like your Instagram posts and stories go away so fast that it just turns into like a hamster wheel once you get it going.
Right.
You know what I mean?
And they're forever changing the algorithm for Instagram.
Yeah, big time. Yeah. Especially now that TikTok smacking them around, you know, it's definitely been way different. Sweet, man. Well, what's she charged for her program?
So she has a 3-month program and then a 6-month program. So her 3-month program right now is at, I think 2,600. I can't think off of my top of my head right now. And I think her 6-month program is at like 5,500 right now. So. A lot of the clients and the stuff that she's gotten feedback from the students, they think that she should be charging way more than what she's charging.
That's a good indication. Yeah, that's a great indication, you know. And I was thinking that too when you were saying 2,600. I was like, dang, man, she could probably do $6,000 for 3 months, you know. In fact, that's what a couple people that we've worked with did. Have you guys ever, you haven't been on one of our live events or like any of our virtual one days or anything like that, have you?
No, I haven't. I'm just now getting to the place where I need to start getting more into live, taking advantage of the lives and certain live shows and stuff, especially with Go High Level and other stuff, because with digital marketing and stuff like that. So to answer your question, no, I haven't.
What I would say is you and your wife should pop on one of our trainings. We have a training this Thursday about sideways prospecting, which is a new way we've been using to generate leads. It's been working pretty crazy and it gets like super high quality lead traffic. That's pretty cool. But we have a couple other things also down the pipe, like of how to use more of the AI to set appointments is one thing we got coming up. So there's like a ton of stuff. And I know your guys' niche pretty well. So I think especially for your wife, it sounds like what she's got, dude, like I would almost just double down on that because she's starting to get the traction. And for you guys to go from where you're at to like 20 grand a month consistent is a lot faster than you might realize.
Okay. That makes sense. And yeah. Not today, but next Thursday.
Well, we have one this Thursday, yeah. And then I don't know if we're going to do one next Thursday. I think we are, but this Thursday for sure, we have the sideways prospecting one.
Okay, and what time is that?
4.
Okay.
If you want, I'll send you the details and you can check it out. If you can make it, cool. If not, we don't do replays just because we like the intimate, like in the moment vibe of it, you know? So there's not going to be a replay or anything, but I'm happy to send you the deets, and if you can make it, make it. And if you can't, then maybe we got another one coming up that you can pop on.
I should be able to pop on today. Tomorrow's my 40th birthday, so I won't be.
Oh, really? Happy birthday.
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
So, are you Virgo? Libra?
No, I'm a Libra.
Libra? Yeah, Libra. Yes, sir. That's cool. I feel like Libras are always so chill. Are you that way?
It depends. I was a Marine, so it just depends.
Oh, you're a Marine?
Yeah, I was in the Marine Corps from 2001 and got out in 2017.
That's cool. That's no joke. My dad and my granddad were both Marine. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah. That's Marines are the toughest for sure.
Yeah.
So that's cool. I'll send you the deets if you want, and then yeah, it'd be cool to see you. And in the sideways prospecting stuff could work pretty well too for some of the stuff you're trying to do with the agency. So.
Okay. Yes. If you can send me the details, I'll definitely be in today.
All right. Easy, man. I'll send you a link, and then and we'll jam on it.
All right.
See you, bro. Happy birthday again. That's awesome. 40 years and more life.
Yes, sir. And where are you going to send the details?
If you want, you want me to just text you on this number? That's probably the easiest, right?
Yes.
All right, yeah, I'll send you a link. And it's a calendar link, so you can just register on the calendar link. And then it's a group call, though. So it's like right now, I think we have like 20 some odd people registered. But, you know, some people always don't show up. You know what I mean? Like Woody Allen's famous joke. Right? 80% of success is just showing up.
Right.
Sweet, man. Well, I'll text you the link on that, and then I'll see you a little bit later today.
Okay, appreciate it.
All right. Happy birthday.
No, thank you.
Bye. Boom. So just like that, we did a call, and I'll run through just a quick recap on what happened. So that was one pickup I got, and I set him to a live event, live training. The reason I did that was because early into the conversation, he had said that he wasn't in a position to invest, which I totally understand. For some people, it just doesn't, like, timing doesn't work out, but that person can end up becoming a great fit over time. And if you notice, like, I didn't let that phase me or anything. I just kept rolling and doing my discovery. And then I ended up finding out, like, this guy's wife is crushing it with her business and in coaching hairstylists, and she's in a really good position. Like, she's got initial traction, she's got some case studies, she just needs a little bit of marketing juice and a little bit of sales, and she can really take that and scale it from the like 2 to 5 grand a month range that she's at right now and get it to 20, 25, 30 grand a month really fast. So I think they'll be awesome people. He seems like a really nice guy and just a good fit overall, so I'm pumped to have him on the training. I'm gonna send him the link right now, but that's how you do it, boys and girls.